here it is, October 4th, 2021, and it is a month before my birthday. And of course, that means it's time for my annual birthday begging video. Now, I'm going to admit that the day kind of snuck up on me because I've been grading final papers over the weekend and, getting to be the ancient age that I am. Maybe senility is setting in a little bit. But my favorite peanut gallery person, Paul D'Augustine, reminded me today that, hey, it's October 4th and you're a little behind. So I thought, do I even want or need to have a birthday begging video this year? None of them have ever produced any results in the past except my devoted followers wish me a happy birthday and they ask questions like, is your hair still long? Yeah, it is. And so on and so on. So considering that my previous birthday begging videos have been rather fruitless, did I really want to do another one? And of course, the answer is yes, because here I am doing another birthday begging V, BBV. I am going to be 69, and that is just a year shy of 70 for you people who are math deficient. Now, I have been telling people I am 69 for at least 2 months, and I still wear my mask. Even though I'm fully vaccinated, I still wear my mask, and one reason why I say I wear my mask is to hide my wrinkles. But when I tell people out in public places, yeah, I'm 69, and they go, you don't look 69, and I toss my hair and say, well, I'm not really 69 yet, but I will be soon. And then point out that they can't see my wrinkles. As in past years, I'm not quite sure what 69 is supposed to feel like. I didn't know what 68 was supposed to feel like. I know that I am in much better health than most other people who are 69. I went for my checkup, I think it was in August, and the nurse practitioner, or that was the nurse, was taking my blood pressure, and she said, how many meds do you take? And I said, I don't take any meds. And she said, wow, she said, that is really unusual for someone your age. I don't have high blood pressure. I don't have any health issues of which I am aware. But when I got in to see the doctor and she looked at my chart, she said, you don't take any medications. Not that I expect her to remember that from last year. And I said, no, I don't. And she said, that's highly unusual for a person your age. And I said, well. And then she told me how healthy I was. And she expected to see me the next year for my checkup. But not in the meantime, unless, you know, I got sick. And I haven't been sick for ages. Just allergies and sneezing every once in a while. So I was also talking to my insurance guy through whom I get Medicare. And he said the same thing. He said, many of his patients have six or more medications, and the average that he was actually reading an article about was about three. So apparently I'm doing okay. Apparently I'm healthy enough for an old woman, and I'm just going to keep doing what I'm doing. I find that I have lapsed back into being pretty much a vegetarian. I've only been eating chicken, and of course I haven't eaten cows or pigs for years. I've only been eating chicken about once a week for the last month or so, and I don't miss it. So hopefully my health will continue. I don't know if the vegetarian diet will have any effect on that or not. It's more just a personal preference than it is for health. There's nothing new in my life. I'm still quilting. Oh, I guess I need to go that way for you to notice the quilt. I'm still quilting, I'm still teaching 5 or 6 classes, and I kept saying, I'm going to cut back when I'm 70. I'm going to cut back teaching classes when I'm 70, and you know something? I'm not going to cut back until I can't teach anymore or can't teach that many classes. So I'm probably not going to cut back until then, because number one, I like the money, and number two, it gives me a purpose in life. And of course, I'm still kind of waiting for Social Security from my ex-husband, but he would have to die before I could get his full amount. And we won't go there because that just seems mean and nasty on my part. So, what do I want for my birthday? Well, I've never gotten a Pagani Zondo. I've never had one person contribute to my cervicoplasty fund. I've just had people ridicule me and ask me, what's wrong with your cervix, Gwen? I wished for, goodwill, peace on earth, and boy, that sure the heck hasn't happened, has it? So I'm not asking for anything for my birthday. I could wish for good health. I already got that. And besides that, the only way I'm going to get good health is through practicing for myself. It's not going to be some sky fairy giving me good health. Life is good for me. I know that it is wretched for many, 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 many people here in the United States and elsewhere in the world. But I'm okay financially. I'm okay emotionally. I don't have drama in my life except with my students who are unhappy with their grades. I step outside my door in the morning and my grass is green and the birds are singing and life is pretty good for me. I've been building my stone walls, built a new one this summer, and gardening. And now that the year is winding down, I admit I do get a little depressed this time of year because I don't like the transition from summer into fall. I don't mind fall so much, it's winter. And I get nostalgic and reminiscent of years past. And it's not that I miss those years because largely I don't, but I miss people. I miss the people who have up and died on me in years past, who meant a lot to me. And I think about them, I think about my childhood friends. And so, yeah, I wouldn't say I get weepy. I just get a little sad. A melancholy is the word that I want. So, all righty then, I'm going to stop rambling. After all, it's at 7 minutes, and I've said nothing in those 7 minutes, and especially nothing new. So, that's my birthday begging video. Be happy, love one another, get vaccinated, and don't be a dumb butt. That's it. Thank you very much, and